Setting up Google Drive desktop. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. In many of the articles that I've written about OneDrive, and there have been many, I often say that it's similar to other tools like Dropbox, Google Drive, and others. In this video, I'm going to set up one of those similar tools, Google Drive. When we're done, it'll synchronize with the cloud and with any other PCs running the Google Drive desktop app signed into the same Google account. Here's the goal. It's really easy to get confused about what these applications do, so I want to start by clarifying where we're headed. The word to remember is synchronization. There will be a Google Drive folder on your computer and a Google Drive online in your Google account at drive.google.com. The Google Drive desktop app has a very simple job. Keep them in sync. That means, I'm going to be super explicit here, if a file is added to your PC's Google Drive folder, it's automatically uploaded to the same location in Google Drive online. If a file is added to Google Drive online, it's automatically downloaded to the equivalent location in your PC's Google Drive folder. If a file in your PC's Google Drive folder is changed, the updated copy is automatically uploaded to the same location in Google Drive online. If a file in Google Drive online is changed, the updated copy is automatically downloaded to the equivalent location in your PC's Google Drive folder. If a file in your PC's Google Drive folder is deleted, the file is deleted from your Google Drive online. If a file in Google Drive online is deleted, that file is deleted from your PC's Google Drive folder. This is so incredibly important to understand. I often hear from people who delete a file on their PC and are distressed and dismayed to find that it's been deleted online as well. That is the whole point. That is synchronization at play. If that's not what you want, then you're not supposed to be using Google Drive. Google Drive is all about synchronization. I'm going to start by showing you Google Drive online. All we really need to do is go to drive.google.com, sign in with our Google account. For this example, it's askleotest@gmail.com with a password. And I have two-factor authentication turned on. Since I don't yet have a passkey installed on this machine, we'll have to get a verification code via a phone number. And we're in. So what we have here is Google Drive in the cloud, drive.google.com. You can store files and folders here. You can have all sorts of things up here. It's just a place to store files. And by default, the free accounts come with 15 gigabytes of available space. You can see here, I actually have three files. I have a document, a PDF, and another document. Remember that for what happens next. Next up is the Google Drive desktop app for Windows. We're going to download that from a specific place. I've got a redirection to it here because it's kind of an odd place. It's actually buried in the support information or help center for Google Drive. We're going to install and set up Drive Desktop for Windows. We'll download it. I'm going to go ahead and open it. Go ahead and run it. Yes. Do you want an application shortcut on your desktop? That's totally up to you. Add desktop shortcuts to Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides. Normally I don't, but because it's not quite what you think, I'm going to go ahead and install these, and we'll see those in a minute when we're done. Google Drive successfully installed. Yay. We'll go ahead and launch. Now, we're not done yet, of course, because we still have to configure it for our account. So we'll go ahead and get started. Sign in. and that will be the same account that we used before. If you're not already signed in, you may be asked to sign in with a specific account, but in this case, since we are already signed in because we took a look at drive.google.com first, we don't have to go through that step again. Go ahead and sign in. Success, we've signed into Google Drive. We can close that window and now go back to the Google Drive app, which is in the process of setting up. Now, we're going to not do a number of things here in setup. I'll try and explain why. Most everything I chose not to do are things we can do later. What I want in this example is the simplest, most straightforward installation of Google Drive. So, we are not going to sync these additional folders, desktop, documents, and downloads. If this sounds familiar, this is very similar to OneDrive's backup, but it's done much better than OneDrive's backup. And honestly, it's one of the reasons that I tend to suggest Google Drive over OneDrive if this is the kind of thing you're trying to back up. The important thing to realize, however, is that these choices, these folders that you list here, are in addition to a folder that will be created specifically for Google Drive. So by not choosing any of these, we're still using Google Drive. There will still be a Google Drive folder. You don't have to choose these. We'll go ahead and skip. Now, it also suggests backup Google Photos. The difference is, for everything other than a photo, what I described earlier about synchronization applies. If you make a change in one place, it gets reflected in the other. As you can see here, it states that when you backup photos, it's not a synchronization, it's a backup. And if you make a change to a file, if you make a change to a photo on your PC, it will get uploaded as a new file. It's really confusing, and I'm not going to turn it on. This is the explanation, but I am going to skip this as well. Now notice you can choose two different folders. Fine, whatever. We're not going to do either of those. Notice in this case that it's actually suggesting a OneDrive folder for the pictures. That's a combination of the fact that, yeah, I've got OneDrive installed on this machine, and my guess is its backup is already turned on. So we're not going to turn on either of these. And I actually do recommend this until we fully understand exactly what the implications are. So skip. That's it. We have pretty much installed Google Drive Desktop. We'll go ahead and click on Next. This is explaining what offline files are about. Very much like OneDrive has its download on demand feature, this is essentially the same thing with a different name. While your files will be listed in the Google Drive folder, as we'll look here in a minute, the contents won't actually be downloaded by default. Now, as soon as you open a file in this condition, Google Drive will download it. So it'll act as if the file were on your PC. You don't change your behavior. But the difference is that there'll be a slight delay while the file is being downloaded, depending on how large the file is. And unless you've downloaded the file by trying to open it, the data is not on your PC. Therefore, the data won't be backed up if that's what you were counting on. So we'll go ahead and open Drive. Well, it didn't open Windows File Explorer, so we'll go ahead and open File Explorer ourselves. And you'll see now that in addition to this, you know, there's the OneDrive folder, but now we have this thing called Google Drive. And if we look at it, we can see a couple of interesting things. Google Drive has been assigned a drive letter. So there's G. That's where you'll find your Google Drive. In that drive, you'll find something called My Drive. My Drive, we'll double click on it, is the contents of your Google Drive online. And you can see, here we have those same three things we were talking about when we looked at drive.google.com. And in fact, if I go ahead and go back to that, you can see here that we have those three documents online at drive.google.com and referenced on our PC in this Google Drive drive. So here are our files and Google Drive in both places, in the cloud and on our PC, possibly without their data yet having been downloaded. If we want to change that, we'll right-click on the file, and unfortunately, we'll have to click on Show More Options because, in Microsoft's wisdom, while they show us the OneDrive options that may or may not be available for this thing, we have to go deeper to see the Google Drive options. And in fact, we can change the offline access for this file. You'll notice that it currently says online only. That means when we open the file, the data for that file will be downloaded right then and there. If we want it to be available offline, we'll click on that. Now you'll notice that the cloud icon for this file has changed to a checkmark. The file's data actually lives on our hard drive. Again, you use the file exactly the same way. The only difference is whether or not the data lives on your hard drive or whether it has to be downloaded from Google Drive at the time you use it. Okay. The thing that's a little bit weird about this, I suspect, is that it's actually set up a different drive, an actual drive letter for this. And if you go looking for your Google Drive files somewhere on your hard drive, they're kind of hard to find. They're buried somewhere down in app data, if I'm not mistaken, in some kind of a cache. However, and this is something that's not obvious from the setup process at all, you might be able to change that. I'm going to go ahead and close this, and we'll go ahead and minimize the browser for the moment. One of the things that got added as part of the setup is down here in the notification area, we have a Google Drive icon. If I click on it, I have the opportunity to view some settings. We're going to go ahead and open the options menu and click on preferences. Now, we do not need to take the tour. Again, this is the adding folders, the documents, desktop folders that I talked about earlier. We're not going to do this. We're going to keep this as simple as possible. However, clicking on Google Drive actually gives us something to think about. We have the option to stream files, which is the default. That's what sets up the G Drive. And that's what basically defaults everything to being from the cloud. However, what I prefer to do, if you have the disk space for it, is to mirror files. You can see here that streaming uses less hard drive space because, of course, all the files are kept online unless you need them or unless you specify that they should be kept on the machine. Mirror is what you probably more or less expect from Google Drive. So if I click on Mirror, now it's going to say, hey, rather than using the drive, G colon, it's going to store these files in users, askleo, which is my current username, my drive. We'll confirm the location. Now we'll hit save. Of course, Google Drive has to restart to make this significant of a change. You can see that the icon is gray while it does so, and then it comes back. All right, we'll click on it. We'll hit preferences once again, and we are now looking at mirrored files. What does that mean? Well, if we fire up Windows File Explorer, we have my drive as a folder. In fact, if you take a look at the full path, it is exactly as promised. Users, askleo, my drive. There's no question about whether it's in the cloud or not. Everything in this folder is mirrored, is synchronized exactly the way I described when we started. If you have enough disk space for the contents of your Google Drive, this is typically what I recommend, because this way you're sure that everything is on your PC and everything is in the cloud. Now you'll notice that there's still this other Google Drive G that's listed here. If I click on it, that says My Drive, and it still shows that stuff. This may or may not remain for you. Technically, this is the drive, but you'll notice that if I do click on the drive, it goes back to the actual folder in my user account. If I go to this PC, you can see that, yeah, there's a Google Drive G. If I go there, that's exactly the same thing. What has happened is the G drive remains, but instead of being a completely separate drive, Ultimately, My Drive just points to the real drive in your user folder on your PC. Now, hopefully that's clear. Bottom line here is use mirroring and you'll have a complete copy of your entire Google Drive on your PC in a folder in your users folder, as well as at drive.google.com. Now, let's talk about Google Docs, shall we? You'll notice that this is a PDF file. And in fact, since I currently don't show extensions, I'm going to go ahead and show that so that you can see what we're looking at here. A GDoc file is a Google Doc. But Google Docs do not have an offline representation. In fact, you'll notice that the GDoc file is very small. It's 1 kilobyte compared to the 3 megabytes that the PDF is taking up. Now, the PDF, of course, is going to be larger than the original document, but nonetheless, that's quite the difference. It's not nearly enough to contain the entire document. That's because Google Docs kept in Google Drive are not actually kept in Google Drive. Google Docs and Google Sheets and Google Slides are all online only. Yes, there is something in Google Drive, but it's a shortcut. If I double click on Internet Safety V6 Free.gdoc, what happens is it fires up my browser and opens up that file in docs.google.com online. That's the only place that document lives. There, like I said, there is no such thing as an offline representation for a Google Doc. There is only online. So that is one thing that can be fairly confusing. Even here, there's a shortcut that says Internet Safety V6 Free. This is online. But even then, if I double click on it, it's again opening up docs.google.com to actually go to the file. So be aware that for all of the files you might throw into your Google Drive, the Google Docs files, the Google Sheets files, the Google Slides files, you'll only see a shortcut there. The actual file itself will continue to remain online and only online. Everything else, exactly as you expect. That's Google Drive. Now, since this has been a bit of a, I won't call it a bumpy road, but I realize that there's a lot of confusing concepts here. In addition to this video, I'm going to suggest that you have a look at the companion article, askleo.com/176266. It essentially is presenting the same information, but in written form. That may be easier to take your time over and understand. But at its most fundamental, Google Drive is really powerful. Google Drive includes 15 gigabytes of free storage, which is more than actually some of the other options, including OneDrive. While you can't always access Google Drive online, running the app on your PC can make it much more transparent. Again, for updates, for comments, for links related to this topic, for a written version, visit askleo.com/176266. Hope this was helpful. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.